SC, welcome back to the Bison Broadcast, where good news grows. This will be our last broadcast of the year. Thanks for watching every week. We've really enjoyed making these broadcasts.
Students and parents, there will be a curbside pickup of supplies next week, May 11th through the 15th, from 4:30 to 6:30 p.m. This will be the time to pick up any belongings from school and turn in your library book. Please check the schedule that was sent out to see what day you should come to school. Make sure you have a car tag with the student's name and stay in your car.
Hello, Station Cam. Just a reminder about the grab-and-go meals. They serve Tuesdays and Fridays from 10 a.m. to noon. Don't forget to check the Sumner County School website for more information.
Here's a big happy birthday shout out to all students and staff that had or will have a birthday between spring break and when we're back in August. We're sad we couldn't celebrate together. Happy birthday! Cotton says happy birthday!
Thank you to all the administrators, staff, teachers, and other participants who participated in the teacher parade. To me, it meant that y'all really care and love for us because y'all took time to be in it.
I'm the one who wants to teach you, miss you all.
Some extra time. Why don't we see what our students have done?
It seems so very wrong that we're not in SE. I think I know where you belong. I think you know it's with me. Can't you see that I'm the one who wants to teach you, miss you all the time? I hope you can see you belong with me.
Family, I'm going to show you something really cool. So what I just did is wrote an expo on this glass container. And what is going to happen is we're going to pour some warm water on it and you'll see what happens. It's really cool. So you'll see that this happens and these letters come up, and so basically you have it right down. If you want to do it at home and have this happen, which is pretty fun, you can write it down on a glass surface with Expo. Make sure it's Expo marker. It can't be Sharpie or any other Crayola or anything like that. It can be other colors, but you want to write it down in the middle, wait about 10 seconds, and then pour warm water in the corner, but make sure it's nice and slow. Don't go too fast. And then you can move it around like this some. That might help get some things up. But once it's here, you can do a couple things. You can just kind of play with it and watch it go around, or you can take and pick it up, which is pretty fun. And it turns that letter into just this little blob, which is pretty cool. Or finally, you can put your hand in another part of your body and you can get it on your hand. So I kind of have that. It might be fun, but it's pretty fun. So if you want to, so from all of us at Bison Broadcast, hope you have a great summer. Bye!
Here are five ways to get rid of your boredom. Number one, you can read a book. Or you can simply just draw a Mother's Day picture. Number three, you can help your parents and clean up around the house. Number four, you can spend time with your sister. Number five, you can play outside. I like playing. So again, these are five ways to get rid of your boredom while you're in quarantine.
Yeah! Station Camp, it's your boy Mr. C coming at you here. All right, let's talk about what we're going to do, what we're going to snack on while we're in this quarantine and going into the summer. All right, this is going to be the big one. All right, I'm going to give you two options here. All right, first option, Gatorade. All right, you think I'm quenching my thirst, getting the electrolytes in me. All right, here's the problem with that. Yeah, that with this. With the Oreo cookie. It's delicious. Both of them. Gatorade and the Oreo Pops. All right, delicious. Lots of sugar. All right, if we're going to eat them, we're just going to sit still. That's going to be a problem with us. All right, what do you got the second option here? Glass of water. Fruit. All right, I go with the oranges. That's Mr. C. I'm an orange kind of guy. All right, listen. You want to go with the water and the fruit over the deliciousness of the Oreo and the Gatorade. Are you my same or sick? You got both. What are you doing with both of them? All right, listen, this is an occasional one. All right, you don't eat this the entire time you're snacking. All right, you want to have this once in a great while, you're doing athletics, something like that. We don't want to drink this while we're just sitting still, all right, at the house. All right, your body is made of this stuff. It's not made of this stuff or this stuff, all right? But the nutrients that fruit gives you, this is what you're made of. You're made of water, all right? The more hydrated you are, the better you feel, all right? That's Mr. C getting you with a quick nutrition update. Keep it real. Peace. I'm out.
Hello, Station Camp. I'm just here to say that now that we cannot leave our house, it's a perfect opportunity to get in some extra reading. Check out some of our favorite books. One of my favorite books is The Secret Garden. It's about an orphan girl named Mary who has to live with her uncle. There's so many rooms in her uncle's house, but she can't go in any of them. When she hears about a secret garden, she wants to explore the backyard to find that secret garden. There's many more mysteries in the house that she finds. It's a very interesting book and it outstanded me. Another of my favorite books is Dork Diary series. It's very funny and it's about a girl named Nikki and she's in middle school and it's about her encounters with her enemy and her crush Brandon and it makes me smile a lot.
We realize it can be easy to get caught up and lost in this world of uncertainty during this difficult time, but we need please take a moment to recognize Dr. Mason, Dr. Jarrett, and Ms. DeVore for staying on their feet and keeping SCE the great place it is and always has.
Hi, Station Camp. So good to see you. We have one last Bison broadcast. So sad that we are not able to be with you, but we wanted to give you a principal's challenge, one last principal's challenge for the summer. So we wanted to get together and talk to you about that principal's challenge. Hope you've enjoyed your time at home. And as you start to get into the summer, your challenge is going to be to learn something new. So think about something that you may want to learn about. It could be a topic or it could be something that you want to do. So we've been thinking about what we want to learn this summer. Dr. Jarrett, what do you want to learn?
So I've been thinking about it and I think I really want to learn to paddleboard. I think that would be good really one. Fun in the sun. I already love to swim. If you don't know how to swim, maybe you could do that.
There
or
you
paddleboard.
Go. I like it. Ms. DeVore.
I want to learn how to make homemade pasta. I absolutely love pasta and I'm tired of buying it at the store, so I want to learn to do that. So maybe you could learn to make a meal for your family.
Nice, nice. I would like to learn this summer a little bit of sign language. I have some things that I want to be able to communicate to other students that may not be able to speak but could learn through sign language. So that's my learning experience this summer. So think about the things that you might want to learn how to do or learn more about. If that's going to be your challenge, we're going to check in with you over the summer on Facebook and ask you to post some things about maybe what you are learning about, so keep that in mind. We miss you guys so much. We hope to see you soon. I hope you can conquer the challenge.
Yay, do it. Bye.
What do you call a pig that can do karate? Pork chop.
Ha ha ha.
What do you call a cow with no legs?
What?
Ground beef. Ground beef.
What do you call a sleeping dinosaur? Dino snore.
Ha ha ha.
Which hand is better to write with?
Which one?
Neither. It's better to write with a pencil.
Two pickles fell out of the pickle jar and onto the floor. What did one pickle say to the other? Deal with it.
Ha ha ha.
What do you call a dog with no legs?
What?
Doesn't matter, it isn't coming. Roxanne!
Hey guys, thanks for watching. We'll be back next year for some more Bison Broadcast fun.
And we want to send a special shout out to our media team. We miss you guys. Thank you so much for doing the broadcast each week, and we cannot wait to see you again.
And as always, be ready, respectful, and responsible. So long.
Toodaloo. Later, Gators. Sayonara. Hasta la sun.